will discuss about principles or laws of inheritance. In the last video, I discussed regarding the monohybrid cross. Mendel did monohybrid cross for all the 7 characters that he has chosen from the garden pea plant. Based on the result of monohybrid cross, Mendel proposed mainly 2 laws, that is, law of dominance and law of segregation. Today, these 2 laws together, it is known as principles of inheritance or laws of inheritance. We'll discuss these 2 laws one by one. First one is law of dominance. Based on the result that the Mendel observed from the monohybrid cross, he concluded that each and every character or each and every trait is controlled by a discrete unit known as factor. So factor is the one which is responsible for each and every character. Anyhow, now we are calling this factor as a gene and its allele. And according to Mendel, these factors are present in pairs. So these factors are always present in pair. Therefore, these paired discrete unit known as factors is responsible for the each and every character or the trait. If you consider an example of monohybrid cross, by taking the character as a stem height has mainly 2 contrasting forms, that is tall and dwarf. So, according to Mendel, there is a discrete unit known as factor which is responsible for the expression of this tall as well as dwarfness in the plant. And he used English alphabets to depict that factor. As you can see here, he used capital T to depict the tallness and small t to represent the dwarf character. So, this capital T and small t and small t are the factor which is responsible for the expression of tall and dwarf character respectively. And according to Mendel, factors are always present in pair. So here, capital T and small t. Since tall plant has both capital T and capital T, it can produce all the gametes only with the capital T. Again, dwarf plant with the small t, it can produce gamete only with the small t. So, when you combine the gamete with the capital T, with the gamete with the small t, you will get a F1 generation plant with the genotype capital T and small t. And Mendel in the F1 generation, he got all tall plants. So, phenotypically, these plants were tall. So, that was the first question that Mendel had. Why only tall character is reappeared in the F1 generation? Or why dwarf character is not reappeared in the F1 generation was a Mendel doubt. And he answered this question using law of dominance. According to law of dominance, when there is a 2 dissimilar factor, one of the factor will dominate over the another factor. As you can see here, this hybrid plant or the F1 generation plant has 2 dissimilar factors. One factor is capital T, which is responsible for the tall character. Another factor is small t, which is responsible for the dwarf character. So, this plant has 2 dissimilar factors. So, when there is a 2 dissimilar factor, one factor will dominate over the another factor. And the one which is dominating will be expressed in the F1 generation. And as you know, the tall character is expressed in the F1 generation here. So, capital T is dominating over the small t. So, capital T, which is responsible for the tall character, is dominant here over the small t, which is responsible for dwarf character. So, small t is known as a recessive trait and capital T is known as a dominant trait. So, capital T is dominating over the small t. Therefore, only tall character is appeared in the F1 generation. So, he answered that question with the help of law of dominance. So, according to law of dominance, when there is a 2 dissimilar factor, one factor will dominate over the another factor. Mendel had one more question in the monohybrid cross. That is, why both the character or how both the character is reappeared in the F2 generation, which was absent in the F1 generation. Here, both tall and dwarf characters have reappeared, but dwarf character was absent in the F1 generation. So, how both the characters have reappeared in the F2 generation was a Mendel question. And he answered this question with the help of law of segregation. According to law of segregation, though the parent have two discrete factor or two factor during the gamete formation, these factors will segregate or separate and each gamete will receive only one factor. So as you can see here, this tall plant has two factor, that is capital T and capital T. But during the gamete formation, it receives only one factor, that is capital T. Again here, it is a hybrid plant having two factor, that is capital T and small t. So there are two dissimilar factor. So though it has two dissimilar factor, during gamete formation, it receives only one factor. So two factor will segregate or separate and each gamete will receive only one factor. So in this case, since the factors are similar, all gametes receives only one factor, that is capital T. Whereas here it has two dissimilar factor, 50% of the gamete will receive capital T and 50% of the gamete will receive small t. So these factors will separate or segregate during gamete formation and each gamete will receive only single factor. Then these gametes carrying these factors will fuse randomly. For example, if we consider these two gametes as a male gamete, that is pollen, and these two gametes as a female gamete, that is egg. So pollen carrying capital T has 50% of chance of fusing with the egg carrying capital T. Again, 50% of chance of fusing with the egg carrying small t. Similarly, a pollen carrying small t have 50% of chance of fusing with the egg carrying capital T and 50% of chance of fusing with the egg carrying small t. So each gamete will fuse with another gamete randomly. So because of this random fusion, in the F2 generation we will get both tall and dwarf plant. So this random fusion is depicted with the help of Punnett square. So as a result of random fusion, both tall and dwarf plant are reappeared in the F2 generation. So that is regarding law of segregation. It is also known as law of purity of gametes, because during gamete formation it receives pure factor. So there is no blending of the factor here. So as a whole, a pure factor or a single factor will be received by each gamete. So that is why it is also known as law of purity of gamete. So that is all about the two laws that is proposed by Mendel based on the result of monohybrid cross. Thank you.